is from Good morning children, welcome to the English class. In today's session we are going to revise chapter number 8 from your grammar book, and the title of this chapter is helping verbs is, am, are, was, were. In the previous chapter, that is chapter number 7, we have learned how is, am, are, was, were used as the main verbs. So in this chapter I am going to explain you again how this is, am, are, was, were are used as helping verbs. They can be used as main verbs also, but today we will learn how they are used as the helping verbs. First of all, you have to remember that another name for helping verb is auxiliary verbs. What they are called? Auxiliary verbs. So remember that we can call them auxiliary verbs also. Now children, am, is, are, was, were can be used as main verbs as well as helping verbs. When am, is, are, was, were are used as helping verbs, they are followed by the main verbs. Means they occur after these, is, am, are, was, were occur after the, before the main verb. So you have to remember that when am, is, are, was, were are used as helping verbs, they are followed by the main verbs which end with ing. Okay children, for example, here you can see I have written one example. My parents are walking in the garden. Now children, here there are two verbs. Are is used as the helping verb and walking is used as the main verb. Okay children, so observe that here the main verb is walking and are is the helping verb. So you can observe that helping verbs always occur before the main verb. Okay, I hope you all know the usage of am, is, are, was, were. Am, is, are is used in the present time. Was and were are used in the past time. Am is always used with the pronoun I. Is always used with the singular noun. And it is used with the pronouns like he, she and it. Are is used with the plural noun and with the pronouns like you, we, they. Okay children, now we will talk about was and were. Was and were we used in the past time. Was is always used with the singular noun and with pronouns like I, he, she, it. Okay children, and it is used in the past time. Was is used in the past time. Okay, and were is also used in the past time when we talk about the plural noun and the pronouns like you, we, they, etc. Okay children, now there are some rules for making the ing form of the verb. So there are few rules for making the ing form of the verb. Let's understand. The first rule is, to make the ing form of a verb, we usually add ing to the verb. Now when we talk about the ing form, the first rule says that we usually add ing to the verb. Verb is given to you. When we add ing to the verb, see here you can see one example I have written here, go plus ing I have written. So here the main verb is go. When we will add ing to the verb will become going. That means we have only added ing to the verb. So the first rule says that to make the ing form of a verb, we usually add ing to the verb. Now what the second rule says, for verbs that end in e, we remove the e and add ing. There are some verbs which end with the letter e. we remove the letter E and we add ing. That means when we have to add ing to the verb which end with letter E, what you will do? You will remove the letter E. Okay, you will drop the letter E and instead of E, you will add ing. For example, you can see I have written come plus going. So here the verb is come. As you can see, this verb is ending with the letter E. So when you will add ing to this verb, what you will do? You will drop this letter E. Drop means you will remove the letter E when you will add ing to the verb. So here when ing is added to the verb come, the answer is coming. So here you can see the spelling of coming, C-O-M-I-N-G. We have dropped the letter E and we have added ing. Okay children, now the third rule says that for verbs that end in L, we double the L and add ing. The verbs which are ending with the letter L, what you will do in these cases? We will double the letter L, means we will write two times L when we will add ing to the verb. So here you can see the example also. I have written cancel plus ing. So here the verb is cancel. You can see that this verb is ending with the letter L. So when you will add ing to the verb, what you will do? You will double the letter L and then you will add ing. So here the spelling of cancelling will be C-A-N-C-E-L-L-I-N-G. Okay children? Now question number fourth is, some example, rule number fourth is, some examples of how the ing form of some other verbs is made. Now here you can see rub plus b plus ing. Here also we will double the letter b. So it will become rubbing, R-U-B-B-I-N-G. When we will add ing to the verb rub, the answer would be rubbing, R-U-B-B-I-N-G. So in this case also you will double the letter B. Okay, and then you will write rubbing. Then hopping. Here also you can see, here the verb is hop. The spelling of hop is H-O-P, hop. When you will add ing to the verb hop, what will be the answer? The answer would be hopping, H-O-P-P-I-N-G. So here also you can observe that we have doubled the letter B and then we have added ing. Now the third example is lie. When you will add ing to the verb lie, what you will do? In this case children, the spelling of lie is L-I-E. When ing is added to the verb lie, what will be the answer? Can you guess? Our answer would be L-Y-I-N-G, lying. In this case, what you have to do? You will remove the letters I and E, both you will remove it, and instead of these two letters, you will add Y and then you will add ing. So here the answer is L-Y-I-N-G, lying. One more example, die plus ing, D-I-E, die. When we will add ing to the verb die, our answer would be dying. The spelling of dying will be D-Y-I-N-G, dying. So here also this verb is ending with the letters I and E. So what you will do? You will remove these letters. You will drop these letters. And instead of these letters, you will add Y and then you will add ing. So here the spelling is D-Y-I-N-G, dying. So children, I hope these rules are clear to you. Understand these rules properly. Okay, now we will do some questions related to this chapter which will be coming in your examination. The pattern will be the same. but the questions will be different. Okay children, so the multiple choice questions are written on the board. You can see, we will understand one by one. The first question is Reena Dash dancing on the stage. Here four options are given to you. Option number A is is, B, M, C, R, and D, were. Now children, you have to use these helping verbs in this sentence. Now here we are talking about only one person, Reema, okay, and this sentence is in the present tense. So in the present tense, I have already explained you, we use the helping verbs is, am, are. So here we are talking about singular person, singular noun. So which helping verb we will use? Yes, we will use is. So here you will write is. So the sentence is Reema is dancing on the stage. Now question number 2 is the students dash sitting in the class. First of all, we have to see that whether the sentence is in the present tense or in the past tense. According to that only you will use the helping verbs. So concept of present and past should be clear. Okay, so here we are talking about many students, the students. There are many students, so noun is plural. So first of all, the sentence is in the present tense and we are talking about plural. So which helping verb we will use? Am, are, is, or was? Yes, we will use are. So here we will write. So the sentence is the students are sitting in the class. Here we will use are because are is always used for the plural noun and with the pronouns like you, we, and they. So here we are talking about many students. That's why we have used the helping verb are. Now the third question is Akash dash absent yesterday. Now children, we are talking about yesterday. Yesterday means the day which has already gone. So this sentence is in the past tense. So in the past tense with which helping verbs we use? Yes, we use was and were. Was is used for the singular noun and were is used for the plural. So here we are talking about Akash. Akash is only one. So we are talking about singular noun. So which helping verb we will use here? Am, were, is, or was? Yes, we will use the helping verb was here. So the answer would be Akash was absent yesterday. Fourth is I am dash water. Now here the helping verb is given to you, and when the helping verb is given to you, what you will do? You will write the verb which is having ing form. We use ing form of the verb when helping verbs are given to you. So here the helping verb am is given to you. So there are four options given to you. A is drink, B is drinking, C is drank, and D is drinks. So which is the correct answer? Yes, option number B is correct, that is drinking. I am drinking water. So here I have used this drinking because in this chapter we have learned that whenever the helping verb is given to you before the main verb, we usually add ing to the verb. So you have to remember this. Question number 5 is she dashed to the market. Now here helping verb as well as the main verb, both you have to select. Four options are given to you. Option number A is going, B is am going, C are going, D were going. Now children, first you have to tell me that this sentence is in the present tense or in the past tense. Yes, it is in the present tense. So here we are talking about she. We are talking about pronoun she. So which helping verb will come? Yes, we will use is. So option number A is the correct answer. You will write is going. Okay children, here you have to identify the correct helping verb, because in every option going is the same thing. So the main thing you have to identify is the correct helping verb. Okay children, now the sixth question is, they dashed cricket last week. Now the sentence is in the past tense, because we are talking about last week, the time which has already gone, the week which has already gone. So here we are talking about past time, that means we will use the helping verb, either was or were. So you can see we are talking about many, as they is used for plural. So we will use the helping verb were here, because I have already explained you, we use were with the plural nouns. So here they is used for many. So we will use the helping verb were here, and we will write playing. So the answer is, they were playing cricket last week. So children, I hope this thing is very clear to you. So revise this chapter very well, so that the concept is clear and you will be able to solve any of the questions which will I give. Okay. Related to this chapter, I have already uploaded one worksheet in document. So you have to do that worksheet by yourself. After that, you can cross-check your answers also. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.